Bop buddy boop buddy.
Z-I-E.
Hello? There you go.
What is it? Z-I-E?
Z-I-E-R-N-O-S.
Z-I-E-R-N-O-S.
So, wait, what?
No. We're recording.
Dun.
All right, I'm sending it, so like...
It already sent.
Here we go.
Hello? I have y'all.
Can you guys hear me?
Oh, you guys are in the Discord.
Yep. Just being unreasonably loud. Here we go. Playing video game. Sir.
Stop.
Sir, that's the wrong. No. Get off Google.
Why?
Because we're live.
I'm gonna search up anything bad.
Hey,
I'm just
gonna
download Discord.
No proof.
And then sign in.
We can't.
Because my password is 58 58 259. It's not the actual password. The actual password is. Hey! No tactics right now. Hey, Austin. No tactics. The mic is on.
The mic is on, and it is live. It's like 30 seconds.
You're just still hearing it.
questions my ability.
Eventually.
Okay.
Well, that was loud as well, but
hello everybody.
I'm Christian.
My first name of many is stories.
And we're just gonna be spectating the game that they're playing right now.
Yeah, so today this is the first day of preliminaries, I believe?
I think so, yeah.
For League of Legends, so we're going to be just spectating their match and seeing how everything goes. Currently, they have already started to pick their characters, so we are going to be watching at a delay like normal, but we are going through and getting all this set up. How do you feel about the enemy team comp having a Pyke Samirin set along with Malphite, somebody that they were not excited to play against?
I don't know, honestly. I mean, it could go either way. They have a good setup on the other team, but it just depends on how they play, mostly. Well, also the characters, but, like, depends on how well they...
It's really going to depend about how the game, team plays this. It's always a turning point.
They're deciding on their final character right now.
Both teams are, yep. Looks Jane. Okay. Yep. Butchered that name, I said Jane.
If you want, there is a mute switch on the side.
Oh, yeah.
The single button right here. And you'll see that will change that little icon to a line to it when it's on.
Where does the line go?
On the bottom, you'll see it right there. So if you're nervous. And if you don't want to be talking, just mute it for a while.
Yeah.
And come back when you have something to say.
Okay. Yeah, we were just kind of talking about.
I know, I was listening
to you.
Oh no. You guys were doing good.
Oh no, I'm tired.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
And here we go, starting off the match like any other. Sitting in the jungle waiting for something interesting to happen. Oh, yeah. Let's figure out how the first encounter goes as Young makes his way to bottom jungle. Here we are at Lightning Fangs, going from taking hits, normal, slow. Starting with Top having a little encounter. Oh, and it looks like Jungle just barely managed to escape. Very first blood was not... didn't get it, so... it's still up for grabs. Bottom seeming to take a lot of hits here, as we are currently witnessing. Oh, and first blood goes to red team. Did in fact sacrifice for that, but still, they got the first blood. So, first blood in this game is bonus gold, which can be used for an advantage very fast early game. And we are still sitting here in laning the phase. Ooh, and another one goes down mid.
Alright, well, I'm back. Keith has to do something else, but I'm back. I got updated one on what's happening, but everything seems to look like happening fine. Both teams have lost. I heard the enemy Samira, if I'm saying that right, I don't think I did, got a kill, but then also died. But good exchange, I guess? I don't know. I haven't been kept up with the game. But everyone seems to be doing all right. Oh, bot lane seems to be pulling something right now. Oh, Drax almost died. That was a close one, but they're backing out right now. Mid seems to be doing all right by themselves as well. Just keeping some distance. Oh, enemy team's trying to keep vision off. Oh, Drax is almost dead. Or, that's not Drax, I don't think so. But they're going after Dragon right now. They cleared all their vision for the Dragon. Oh yes, they're attacking Dragon right now. Well, it looks like they backed away from Dragon a bit. Just keep them watch. Top has almost got the enemy team's top. Oh yeah, they're getting dragged right now. Trying to keep off. See who gets to steal the dragon. Oh, team, our team has gotten the dragon. They stole it. So that's a fail on the enemy team. Well, fail to try to get dragon. Top and mid have gone back to base to get some items or heal as well. Wait, not mid. Just top. Oh, top and Lux from bottom. The enemy team bottom is trying to pull something right now. Looks like they might get all the kills. Won't know. That was a close one, but oh, oh, enemy jungle tried to. Oh, they might get this kill. And flash. Oh, they got Chrono Fire. And they're going off another. Now both scores on kills are now equal.
Oh, bot got another kill just right now. Lux got our third kill. Oh, they might be going after the last enemy on bot. Yes, and they successfully got that kill as well. Now they'll be going after tower, and hopefully doing some damage to that. Oh no, just dashed out of there. Enemy try to steal, try to grab dragon while they're on watch, but they stole dragon and then from that they got a kill, I think. Does seem to be going good for our side, though.
Mass amounts of pings be like.
What do they get right now?
Smear is just looking a little annoying. Smear is just been hit by a Lux.
Lux is old, right?
Oh! Satisfying another kill.
Another
two
shutdown.
Kills. King shutting down Young?
I think it was a Young.
Jungler v jungler. It's very common to see in this game.
Mm-hmm.
It's just interesting to see how everything plays. Because lots of people have their own play styles.
Oh yeah.
Blue team getting dragon right here. Solidifying soul.
Yeah, that's the second dragon.
Well, not solidifying soul. But being able to view it.
Top is probably going to try to get tower right now. So where's Austin at right now?
He seems to just be running back up the lane. Gauge poison.
They got another kill. What is that? This,
was going to say some Metra, but that's Overwatch.
That was Soraka getting another kill on Samira bottom. Normally, you don't see a support going through and taking kills from bottom, but well, here we are.
We did lose mid tower.
Well,
I just saw that.
Red team proceeds to take first tower. It's another.
Oh yeah, that is first tower. Oh, Austin to them. Seems like he's gonna die right now.
Ooh, and Top getting jumped by two people.
Something but we did get bottom tower though. We got bottom tower though. That's good. Now both bots are going back to get items, I think. Hopefully. Stole their. Okay, that's just PM. He just stole his whatever he was farming and then emoted.
Who did?
I think our jungle. We're jumping on him.
Main is proceeding to speak. Top proceeding to get jumped by blue team. A little bit of revenge, as people would say. Set telling Top to stop Lola Bear from trying to escape, but it doesn't seem to be working. Maybe you see Set die here. Yeah. Giving blue team another kill.
Ooh, that was a close one for that one. And there it goes. And another shutdown.
There's another shutdown for Volibear. Interesting plays.
Oh, and then we did lose our. What is that?
Yon shut down Soraka. Wait, what happened here?
Somebody we lost Soraka. Yeah.
Soraka was killed by somebody. I'm guessing that was Samira.
I think so, yeah.
Was it a female?
I think so as well. Yeah, I don't know. They're trying to get, what is that? I forgot. That's Bear. No, it's not Bear.
Oh, and there goes Blue Team taking Rift Herald, one of the very limited time events that you can get. That'll definitely push the favor in Blue Team's side. And they're using it topside.
Oh wow, okay.
Blue team taking red tower, that's actually a huge play.
That's two towers for us and...
Taking top and bottom tower. The fact that Kane is currently getting pushed here, that may change a lot of things. Barely managing to escape.
That's a close one. Right after, I think, Austin went back.
I wouldn't say names, I would say characters.
Okay.
Nash are coming up in 5 seconds, and by the looks of it, blue team definitely wants to try to take it. Or at least just make sure everybody knows that it's there and up for grabs. And here we are having a conflict in jungle. Flaming phase is done, so this wouldn't be out of the ordinary.
No team took a major loss, but just a little battle. No, I said no team got a loss. Oh, well, there's a loss right there.
That does happen to be a loss. They're bottom, very squishy characters getting...
Lux keeps on getting every
3v1. Kill. 3v1. Lux do be taking kills, but that's reasonable. They are playing a carry. And there it is, blue team taking another Drake, proceeding to lock out the enemy team, 3 Drakes to their 9. Will blue team be able to get the 4th Drake? I guess we'll find out here in another couple of minutes.
They are taking the next
mid tower. Oh no, the first tower in mid. So now every top, bottom, and mid have gotten their towers destroyed. First tower destroyed. Or I think so. Or have they also taken second bottom tower?
Not bad. That's one tower for each lane. I think they may be trying to go for a split push here. Due to the fact that, I mean, all three lanes have lost one tower. That's not something to go through and just say, oh, well, they're just going to do this one strategy. They could definitely do something different, but here we are watching top of Wolimir trying to fight Malphite, two very tanky characters with their own set of annoyance from playing this video game, I can definitely state. And it is a little bit annoying. And here we are set their middle laner, something you don't normally see much often. Ooh. Play of trying to 1v2 their bottom and jungle. But here comes the bottom and support proceeding to go through and assist their teammate.
Looks happy.
2v1 into a 3v2, proceeding to take out both players while Volibear gets killed top jungle.
Was that three people on the team died? Wow.
He got caught just away from the team. And currently on death count, we have two people that died on red, so, and three on blue. So definitely red did get the proper exchange they could have wanted from that.
Top tower does seem normal as well. I might try to push that.
Yeah, so red team does have the middle and top tower. I think they may just give up on bottom tower, but only time will truly tell how that will play out. Here we are watching, red getting another kill on enemy set. Not for a shutdown, but that Yone is definitely on a killing spree.
Almost about catching up to kills as well, just four more in there. Catch up to our side with 12 kills.
You can definitely see by the way that each team is playing is they're definitely trying to play defensive unless they have the numbers. And It is definitely working for most people. I guess we're going to try to figure out how the rest of this is going to go because, I mean, we're only 24 minutes in and it still looks fairly even. Oh, and here we go, having another exchange mid.
There's another kill.
Instantly, Kane going through and taking the kill with Samira.
That's bottom tower.
While Set does a split push and takes bottom tower while nobody is looking. Oh no. Very interesting exchange. I think the set wanted to try to do that because that puts them up for a more of a push. Due to the fact that they have proceeded to split the entire enemy team. And here was Young taking a couple of pokes at Lux. Could definitely go through and do something off that.
Lux was going back from here, deciding on which to stay.
Just going back and forth, man. Here we are, Ren taking vision away from blue in jungle. Very smart thing to do, so they can see objectives. Still no team is trying to go for Baron yet. I think Volibear may have tried, but then instantly got shot down.
Yeah. Oh, I think Drake maybe coming back? No, I don't think so.
That did seem to be Drake. Yeah, Drake now is back, in fact, by looking at that minimap. Drake is truly back, and the red team is going to try to stop blue team from taking this drink, because if blue team does get this drink, that does mean they do get Earth Soul, which can go through, and Earth Soul just gives a bonus shield and makes people tanky.
Team fight.
Here we go, team fight. Red proceeding to take the first blood in this game. Everybody seeming to be low. Blue taking two kills off of them.
Three,
actually. Oh no.
One.
We're watching some very interesting stuff here. And that's four.
Oh.
Blue maybe getting Drake in four that soul, and Red might. Trying to stop it. It just completely failed.
Oh. He's lasting pretty long.
There it is. That's just a team wipe.
Yep.
Team wipe. So Blue is completely uncontested for another 30 seconds. Definitely, they could definitely do a lot off of this. Getting Rock Soul, Rock Drake Soul,
yeah.
Definitely a big boost to their survivability, giving them that extra shield. Nobody really seem to want to go for that Baron
now. Yeah. Everyone seems to be going back to get items. And just...
Definitely a smart move on a lot of people's behalves, getting that extra mana, getting their mana back and health to do that team fight. While we're witnessing Red proceed to emote for no reason. I don't know if that's toxicity or not, but I mean...
Do what they want to do, I guess.
I mean, it may have just been because he wanted to, not because it was trying to be toxic.
Some fun.
It's actually very interesting. ADC takes red buff. Kane is just going through, minding his own business, taking wolves.
They do seem to be pushing mid.
Here we go. Maybe another team fight for tower. Yeah. I mean, we're watching them take blue team takes red tower. Kind of easily. No contesting there. But we're also currently witnessing Set on the map go through and proceed to push bottom solo.
Oh, he is. And no one seems to notice.
Oh no. Well, somebody definitely noticed, but was it? Not in time. They definitely can salvage this, but can they get this set?
No one does. Oh, they are going for Baron right about now. I think one of our. Who is that?
Oh, yeah, as we're currently witnessing, we're watching top team both Soraka and Volibear trying to take out the Yone and Malphite. Working fairly decently, and there's Volibear missing his ultimate, trying to jump over the wall. Very sad way to lose your ultimate as Volibear. And there is Red getting two kills, a shutdown on Volibear for 150 gold, and killing the Soraka at the same time. There's two people down, blue team, with red team having the lead on teammates for the next 30 seconds. Definitely could change here. And here we go. Here's Kane proceeding to rush in solo and take on the entire team, killing one. And will he get a second? Maybe.
Does seem to happen well, though.
Just so close, yet he just couldn't land the last hit. But like here's the rest of the team showing up, finally.
And the enemy team is low, so they'll be trying to run away.
Red team is definitely low. They're about to lose both of their tanks. There's one of their
tanks.
Ooh, Set here with his survivability. And there's two tanks gone. Red team being limited to only their bottom and their support character. Really can't make much of a play off of that.
I do think they'll be going after Baron.
Blue team trying to take Baron right now. Very smart idea considering two people are down and out.
Oh, they're backing out just to get some health maybe.
Oh no, Kane died to Baron. That could also be why they're trying to back away, which more likely is. because you lose your ability to go through and take from Baron when he gets in without having it getting stolen. And Minion? No, Zed taking top tower.
Top tower, yeah.
That's definitely gonna switch the entire change of plan for Red Team. They're probably gonna play more defensive due to the fact that they are losing towers.
Yeah.
I definitely feel a split push going on here, but I mean, they haven't shown any signs of them split pushing yet.
Clap. I think that's in.
I think it is.
I mean, we have Lux going through and trying to notify the team that Elder Dragon, a very lethal weapon when you have a lot of damage, being able to just instantly execute somebody for 25% of their health.
It does look like
every... I believe it's 25%. I think it may be 10.
I think it's 10.
But here we are, another team fight for Dragon, but now this one isn't an objective. This is an optional. This doesn't give soul, but this does boost all of the current souls a team has and gives them the ability of execution. Basically, execution is upon somebody's HP reaching a certain amount, they take damage, they just die. There's no real way to put that. And right now we are currently witnessing blue team and red team trouble, just trying to poke each other, trying to see who can get the first lethal hit to try to get that Elder Dragon. Both teams, full team 5v5 is there, so I guess we'll see something. Oh, and there's another poke on the Zed who is trying to flank behind them. I mean, your flank didn't work very well, but here we are. Red team proceeding to push back in the tower. Maybe a good decent thing. And wait, there's Yone ultimate pushing in, trying to initiate, and there it is. Red team's trying to initiate against blue. Saraka ult has popped.
Three. That's
Saraka ultimate popped. And blue team gets 3-4 kills.
Might be teamwork again.
No. 4 kills? They're not going to go for the 5th. Makes sense, he did run back. I believe we're about to watch blue team here take Elder Dragon. Very, like I said, very lethal weapon. Definitely can do a lot of damage with that.
Yeah, Velbear's going for the bottom tower, and then the rest of the team is going for the dragon.
Yeah. Looking at now,
it's the red
nobody really alive to contest a dragon, so blue team getting this for free. Lux ultimate getting fired off again. Very, very multitude there. It's got a very small cooldown. I believe it's like maybe 60 seconds, so it's very fast.
And there it is, blue team taking another kill off Samira.
Lux definitely run away.
Lux definitely doing something here. Proceeding to get pulled back, and there's the pike execute. Definitely giving the set and him bonus gold while getting rid of soul off of that Venera Lux. Soraka is also dead. While we have Kane rushing in from the top, proceeding to go through and take out both Yone and Set.
Oh no, that was the third kill.
Yone, Set, and Samira are all down right now.
Might try to push top tower right now, I think.
Definitely clearing minions top. And yeah, by the looks of it, yeah, they're definitely going to take
top.
They're definitely going to push it. And uncontested, taking top tower.
Top tower, yeah. That's the last top tower, I believe, so.
And there it is, Zed proceeding to take Yone along with his team and going through and taking two towers. Both towers on Red Nexus have been destroyed, and here we are watching Volibear proceed to just bully somebody for no reason.
There goes everything, and so now they'll be going after that.
The team is currently on blue team ending game. That is game one, everybody. Game two will be starting shortly, and we will be back with that. Well, with commentation, at least.
Questions my ability.
Here we go, them going through and changing sides while going through and setting up for the next match. And here we are with the first two bands of Viego and also Wukong. Very interesting bands there.
Thank you. The weak fear the shadows.
Fear controls them.
You are right to fear my greatness.
Fear is the first of many foes.
What must be done?
Fight you can't win.
Thank you.
to Summoner's Rift. Thirty seconds until minions spawn.
And we are back to currently in match two. As we can clearly see, each team proceeded to swap sides of the map. So now blue team is on the away team, and red team is on the home team. You usually always do that after a match. It doesn't change much. But as we're clearly seeing right now, the enemy Yami has used Red's Yami has used Flash. Currently the team lineup does in fact happen to be considered of their top laner being Mordekaiser, jungle being Yi, and also, as we clearly saw right there, Mordekaiser is taking a couple pokes at Bulbasaur right here. We're watching them just take a couple pokes at each other. See, there it is again. Mordekaiser trying to go through and get that easy early damage. While same with mid lane. Everyone just having to go back to their lanes. Back to the team comps. We're currently witnessing blue team is Mordekaiser, Yi, Nocturne, Jhin, and Thresh. Very normalish team comp. Don't really see much difference in the normal team comp from this. And then on the red team, we have Volibear, Kha'Zix, Kassadin, which is a new character that we haven't seen yet. We also have Caitlyn, which is our now new bottom, and Nami playing support. I'm very interested to see how this one goes, and I think we all are. Middle lane is still taking pokes at each other, and there's the fear. Red mid laner Kassadin losing a lot of health. Bulbasaur proceeding to lose a lot more HP. Mordekaiser is definitely just bullying the Bulbasaur right now, and jungle coming up from long jungle to gank top. Ganking happens to be considered of their jungle, which is a roaming character. Jungle is not restricted to a lane, while nothing interesting is happening except for red pushes tower. I guess I should explain that. ADC, bot, that and support usually stay bot lane. Their main purpose is to just push bot lane as far as possible during the first 15 minutes. This is all during the laning phase. Middle lane, you have Kassadin versus Nock. Basically, mid is the most aggressive and passive. They're basically a passive-aggressive lane. I'm going to be the only commentator right now. Other person, I believe. It's all good. Currently though, we are watching Kassadin. They're a mid is just poking back and forth. Same with top. There's first blood. Mordekaiser getting first blood top. That's definitely gonna put it in the favor of blue team for right now, but it all can change just like it did last time. And there it is, bottom proceeding to get hooked in by Thresh and losing a lot of health. This is very, very wild. So yeah, back to what I was saying. The Kha'Zix and Master Yi, their main goals are roam.
basically they are not limited to one area. They are not restricted by any boundaries at all. They can do as they please. Also, as we clearly just saw right there, a Yeep is attacking and there it is. Yeep taking Infernal Dragon. Giving Infernal Dragon gives a bonus to both physical damage and magical damage. Going through, making it, I think it's 5% better, more damage. And that's going to be first Drake. The way Drakes work, while there's nothing interesting happening right now, is that Drakes go through and there can only be four obtained. Three Drakes appear every game. The third Drake in this initially states that soul goes through, depending on the Drake, gives boost. Right now, we are watching knocked back away from mid. A jungle was there. They definitely got poked hard, but here's knocked back out. Teleporting back. Knock being out of flash and teleport along with everything that's happening. Very, very hard to keep up with this all because it's just going very quickly. But currently the only death has been top lane. It's always going to be a back and forth struggle. It just depends on how it goes. And here it is, jungle going through, attacking. And there it is. Yi proceeding to die, well, killing the Kha'Zix, going on with his day, with the Yi getting assistance from Nott. Caitlyn proceeding to press on Yi and try to attack him, getting pushed off by Nott and Jhin. Yi actually managing to make this out of life. And here's Thresh pushing in as well, just to force Caitlyn off just a little bit more. Red team definitely at a disadvantage right now, but that all could change. Only time will tell, along with skin. Bottom proceeding to take pokes back and forth at each other, doing a little bit of damage at a time. Little bit of button mess up. But we're back. People proceeding to go through continue to still poke at each other more. Guys are full HP with ultimate, while Volibear is top with half HP and all. Very interesting to see there. This is just a back and forth struggle right now. We're about 9 minutes in, and still losing the lead, but I can all change in any time. Oh no, is support getting hooked? Does support die here? No. Okay, there we go. Red team managing to get away without dying against the enemy. It's giving them bonus gold and EXP. Bot lane looking to be extremely pushed right now, while we have Mordekaiser and Volibear proceeding to aggress on each other. Volibear proceeding to lose a lot of health. And Volibear going down, Red getting another kill. That's Mordekaiser's second kill. Or third. I have no idea. But here we are anyways. I believe it was second kill. Cassidy going down once. Yeah. Oh, he didn't even state. Yi getting Rift Herald and proceeding to summon it top lane. Blue team is managing to do the exact same thing. Red team did the first game. Pushing it straight back. Red team destroying Yi. Rift Herald. Going through, definitely setting a solid line for themselves right now, while Yi being half HP may go assist mid lane right now. We'll never know. Oh, actually. Is currently doing his own thing, which Autumn isn't that out of the ordinary. Rocketer does, Mountain Break does have to be up right now. We will probably see Yi take it here in a second, just to give his team that extra bonus defense. Going for a Mountain Drake. Definitely lucky to be red team out, but red team still managing to sneak in a kill there. I need killing Yami, that's a support down. Mid also going down. Blue team getting at least two kills. That pushes red team back a lot. Thresh also did die though, but he is already back up and going down. Still anybody's game right now. Blue team does have Drake and Coward advantage. Not so much tower advantage right now. Just watching people go back and forth poking for 12 minutes in. Laning face shaking at him. You're seeing people shaking, roaming more, attacking than the right side. Guess we will see eventually.
Killing spree.
Ooh, and there it is. Mordekaiser proceeding to take down Volibear. Was very a little bit slow on that. I did not. That was also Volibear's ultimate. Those red spikes there. Those were, not spikes, but flames. That is Mordekaiser's ultimate for people who are not in the realm. People in Mordekaiser's realm ultimate is, final ability goes through and locks people in a circulation realm where they cannot escape. It is just a 1v1 arena. And that's what happened to Volibear there. Basically, if Mordekaiser can beat the person he puts in that realm, he gets a small stat increase from that person's stats. I'm here, not this going through the bottom. We had Kha'Zix proceed to attack the gym just a little bit. Just a little poke. But, bottom, red being pushed away from bottom, straight back into tower, but Jin using ultimate here. Will Jin be able to just take a free kill? Using his ultimate? No, he didn't. Very close, though. Very close. Two tower shots. Don't know if that'll come into play anything. Oh, and there it is. Kha'Zix shutting down the Yi for 500 bonus gold. Definitely going to assist them in the later of the match. And blue team taking first tower on middle. Definitely going to help blue team continue their reign over this game. And there it is, Kha'Zix proceeding to take down Nott as well. That is two kills for that Kha'Zix right now. He's definitely doing work. Volibear and Mordekaiser are taking a couple of hits at each other. Volibear losing that trade health-wise, but I mean, that's predictable. Do Mordekaiser have any defense? top lane, proceeding to go through and get pushed by Yi here. But Yi instantly backs out. No, maybe not. Are we able to see a couple of predictions here for top role? Oh, never mind. Casting is here. Never mind. Oh, Noct is also here. Pushing this fight into the 3v2. Volibear getting one kill on me, but then sadly, Cassidy dying to Mortizer along with Volibear. Volibear then getting shut down by Tower. I mean, there's not much you can say about that. He overstayed his welcome, and that gave Volibear a free shutdown on Mortizer. Both objectives are currently up, but here we go. Kha'Zix proceeding to go to attack Noct. Noct proceeding to try to get away. He may or may not. And there it is. Kha'Zix proceeding to snipe Noct for that kill, getting him some bonus gold. And trying to set his team back on the right track to win. Blue team having two turrets to red team's zero, and also having kill advantage. Only time will tell. Blue team also having more drakes. Could we be watching at a reverse game here where red team gets, well, yeah, home team gets destroyed and loses? Maybe. But they could definitely come back. But Jin going through, dashing away, and forcing the Nami to use ultimate and not getting the kill. There's Yi getting a double kill on both Nami and Caitlyn, proceeding to go through and put that Yi at a fed state. Yi being fed probably isn't the best idea for games like this, due to the fact that Yi being fed definitely means Yi can buy a lot of bonus stuff and can turn the tide of battle very quickly. Here we are watching Volibear proceed to fight Noct top. Wasn't a deadly engagement, they just kept sitting, poking each other and running. He's taking blue buff from his enemy. Very intelligent play if you're trying to get through and you're in the lead. And look at this, a 3v3 bot, 4v3 bot, and Yi proceeding to kill the Nami. Definitely setting them at the additional pace here, and Volibear coming from all the way from top to assist his team. Does he manage to do anything here? He uses ultimate, and there's the Yi shutdown by the Caitlyn. Caitlyn getting some bonus gold for a free shutdown. Cassidy proceeding to get hooked by Thresh and killed thanks to Tower. Just barely saving himself from the Mortizer dying to Tower. There's Kha'Zix proceeding to steal a Jin kill. Very decent replay. Mortizer used ultimate on Caitlyn. That's why he has that picture of her next to him. He is proceeded to be buffed by all of Caitlyn's items. He gets to take that full boost of 20% of their stats and use that. So here's a current situation. That blue team is down 2 players. Down 2 players currently due to blue's 1, now 0. Everybody's fully revived. But the problem being is blue team has a lot more team fight capability than red. So naturally I feel like this is going to be a win for blue, but like I said, things can change. We saw it change first game and it could happen again. Oh, and here we are watching blue team take Nashor. Nashor is a buff that'll help everybody on the team who takes it. Basically making minions stronger, you taking less damage, you doing more damage. And it's just an all-around huge stat increase for the team. And there it is. You proceeding to take Nashor with Thresh and I believe that was Jin's help. Definitely going through setting the win towards their favor. But it could still change. Just because you get that doesn't mean you're going to win that. Oh, and Rift Herald top. Blue was saving Rift Herald this entire time until they got their buff. Rift Herald going down top, not being able to take a tower, but Nacht was not about to fight a 1v2. And here we are watching Kha'Zix proceed to take out Jin and go through. He was going to try to probably do more there, but Nami went through and died to Thresh and Mordekaiser. Nothing much you can really do there because, well, you can't. Like, all in, there it is. Red team taking Ocean Break. Ocean Soul is on the field. Basically, Ocean Soul is every time you use an ability, you heal for the damage. I believe it's 20% of the damage done. And also, there is Mordekaiser killing Kazadine. That's putting blue team at a lead against their opponent of red, having 3 people dead. That is, we're currently looking at 18-9 at a 23 minutes. Still, that Drake may have possibly saved them. Just a little bit longer, we won't know. Red team still having no towers taken. Definitely a big problem there. You have to get through the towers to get to the base. That's the only thing that you can do. Blue team looking at a fine game here, taking 4 towers compared to the enemy's 0. And taking all of the objectives except for that one Drake. Here's Kha'Zix getting hooked by Thresh. Oh no, Mordekaiser bopping Caitlyn with his Q. Doing a lot of bonus damage. And here we are watching Volibear get just bullied. Oh, and bullied back. Guess we won't figure out how that one ends. Oh no, Nock is back in itself. Red team proceeding to get sucked into dimension. Oh no, Caitlyn. Caitlyn losing in dimension against Mordekaiser, giving Mordekaiser that bomb. Not much Caitlyn could have done there. Kassadin getting rushed by Yi in the spawn. Well, in the base. Kassadin proceeding to die there. And Red Team finally getting first tower top. That's what you get when you drop your guard. Red Team proceeding to take tower all the way to mid and bottom. Definitely a huge problem there. Blue team taking red inhib as well. Could we possibly be looking at a game 3? Mordekaiser also taking red tower bottom.
pushing them all the way back on their base two sides. And taking red and definitely putting red on a very defensive state here. But there's Volibear shutting down Flesh. But Mordekaiser proceeding to still get a double kill and leave with his life. There's Yi proceeding to take out Mommy. Could we be looking at a team wipe here? Red proceeding to lose another tower, but to knock this time. This putting them at one tower closer to losing. But here's blue team backing off. They could have definitely ended the game there. Red team trying to recover from their current situation. Ooh, it looks like blue team is trying to take Ocean Drake in a minute. A little bit of hostility downtime. People aren't trying to fight each other as much. Maybe a little bit of something top. Maybe trying to brew. We won't know just yet, will we? Looking at a little bit of a, oh no, Thresh getting jumped by three people. And there goes Thresh, not also pushing in. We are seeing a 3v3 here. The Jin proceeding to take out Nami from a range with his ultimate. And there goes Red using another character. Mordekaiser proceeding to take another one out. We'll see Mordekaiser get a 3 kill here. But there it is, blue taking Soul. Ocean Soul definitely, like I said before, helps the team out, gives everybody that free health off of using an ability. Definitely a very powerful weapon, just like Earth Soul, Mountain Soul. Oh, and here's Mordekaiser taking Cassidy into his 1v1, not proceeding to kill him. There's also blue team, if you didn't get to see, but Yi taking out Baron Nashor King, giving blue team the biggest boost possible again. Could we definitely be looking at the end of this match? Probably, but it all depends on how blue team wins this, because red could possibly still win. Oh, Mordekaiser taunting. He's trying to get into something there. Proceeding to get poked twice and lose a decent bit of his health. Here's Yi running up against Volibear. Volibear proceeding to back off. Yi not pushing after. Nock is pushing top side. Very interesting. Yi taking red tower top. And he's probably definitely looking for a match here. Fresh hit base. Quickly on defensive for Red Man. Mordekaiser down. Definitely recover this. Oh, and there it is. Cassidy proceeding to take out Flesh. Definitely proceeding to do something with that. Yi taking out an intake top because nobody can contest him. He takes out Caitlyn. Oh, does he proceed to? He got Yumi. He got Cassidy. Could he end this game? No. Kha'zix proceeding to go through and attack the Ophidian's passive, taking out Totsky and Arthur's killing spree. And there it is. The second match ending with a score of 1-1. Here we go.
We are currently going through. They started the second match. Well, they started the third match without waiting to invite the spectators. So we are currently waiting for their match to start. As you guys can clearly see, we can't spectate match. We're waiting for their match to start before we go through and are able to spectate them. But once that is available, well, you'll find out. Well, you'll be able to see. And here we go. As we can clearly see, they did swap teams again. So the first game, that team is back on blue side. Red side is back on red side. So as we can clearly see, that this team's lineup is going to be comprised of blue team having Set, Warwick, Nautilus. I completely forgot the other two's names. I'm sorry. And then red team is comprised of Morgana, Aphelios, Ziggs, Yumi, and Mordekaiser. You'll be able to see those other two names when it actually shows us the screen when it starts to load in a minute and 40 seconds.
Welcome to Summoner's Rift.
Here we go, the beginning of the third match. I think this is definitely going to decide whether which team moves on. Having Morgana jungle, that is not a very normal pick. And I guess we're going to be seeing how that goes through and plays out for red team here. Due to the fact that this is the very last match. Each team having a very normal-ish comp, except for that Morgana. I'm really interested to see what they happen to do with that. And we are about to start to kick things off here in about another 10 seconds when the game finally starts and people start doing the things. It's only a matter of time to see what truly will comprise of this match. Conspire? Yeah, that's the one. Conspire out of this match and go through and do something. Not taking exchange at each other, same with mid, same as what last had the last game, but it's different. There it is, bottom finally initiating, but easily gets pushed off by Ziggs and his satchel charge. Mordekaiser and Sam taking pop shots at each other, both of which are still max HP. Mordekaiser is max HP, and well, set not so much, but really depends on how this plays. Bottom lane still just sitting in a bush while they clear jungle. Well, minions. But they clear minions. Here it is. Two red inside of blue's jungle. Set proceeding to try to take a 2v1 here. Getting stunned? Definitely a big play from Morgana. Then back to bottom here. Well, we're watching first blood on Kalista. Going through and taking that first blood. Blue team getting that bonus here. We will see which team, each team trying to plant their best. Mordekaiser going through and proceeding to take out enemy, well, blue team Warwick. Netting the game at 1-1. Keeping a blue team lead is only that first blood. Oh, here we go. Ziggs going through using another central charge to break away there, but Kalista getting sniped in the process. Both Kalista and Nautilus, that's the one. Got mixed up from last game. Proceeding to go through and tank half HP while the first Ziggs is still full. Mordekaiser pushing Set back here. Set is at a losing advantage in health.
His passive is really what happens here, and that could definitely change the match. Forgot to comment on that. Sent going through getting killed by Mordekaiser. Definitely giving Mordekaiser the lead there, but here we are back at... I'm gonna keep failing his name. Nautilus. That's the one. We're seeing him get a kill there on Yumi. Each person looking at an equal exchange of events, trying to go through and see what could be positive for them during this match. Nothing much happening though right now. First strike is in fact up, and it happens to be Cloud Drake. Cloud Drake goes through and reduces the cooldown on people's ultimates, going through and just making it so they're a little bit faster. So, people who really get that, it's beneficial for people who have a really, really long cooldown, but if your cooldown's not that long, it really won't benefit you much because it's percent-wise. Both objectives, though, currently being up, happening to be Rift Herald and also Cloud Drake. Oh, Warwick was getting approached in general by, Aphelios. Nothing, no engagement happening there. They both back off very, very fast. We're going all over the place. Solid hit from Mordekaiser right there. Another thing I forgot to mention is the way that Mordekaiser's passive works is every three times he hits somebody, he goes through and he applies an area of effect that does a little bit of extra damage. So he's definitely close range tank. So he can tank a lot of damage, do a lot of damage, and just be an all-around useful character. There's Yumi Ultimate. Oh no, Yumi Ultimate proceeding to kill Callista. Something you don't see very often. Due to the fact that Yumi Ultimate doesn't do much damage, but there was. Malphite. I completely forgot his name already again. Sorry. But he getting another kill with Warwick's help. all of blue team's ultimates seem to be on cooldown except for Set, but all of red team except for Ziggs and Yumi have their ultimate, so you can definitely, you definitely could do something here to help push away enemy, well, push away blue team. The game is currently tied, 4 to kills, 4 kills, 0 towers, 0 towers. We're going into the 11 minutes. Something could change here, something couldn't change here. Ziggs killing Callista here, very close, and Ziggs getting a double kill on Nautilus as well. Blue team getting shut out, double kill bottom lane, 3 people bottom lane on red, definitely did something there. Morgana definitely being low, getting healed though. She backed all the way back to base to heal. A very smart move on her play. Warwick in jungle, we are just getting put into a fight against both. Oh no, 4 people, Yumi, Ziggs, Morgana, and Furious. We're seeing him get a double kill, triple kill. That means both the middle laner, the bottom, the support, and their jungle are all down. That could definitely be a turning point in this match. Does blue team get a kill here using their Callista? Does Callista get a kill? Callista getting looted into an easy Morgana damage. Nah, Callista going down here to Ziggs, putting Ziggs on a killing spree. That could be a shutdown if they can do some kind of play. And there it is, red team smiting Cloudrake to go through and get a free soul, and there it is, Warwick also proceeding to go down. Vent going through Lidding, they're more gonna get away with that kill. Then it's also First Dragon. That could change everything from this point on, but well, First Dragon really didn't do much, except it could be perspective, people get hurt. And they're set, proceeding to get bombed by Mordekaiser, losing in the 1v1 arena. Very disappointing to see, but there's nothing much you can do there. Mordekaiser is meant to just control 1v1s. And here it is, Mordekaiser taking the very first turret of the game, proceeding to put red in a lead of 1 turret, 1 dragon, and 8 additional kills with a whole lot of bonus gold. has equal exchange from bottom. Only problem is that human death makes it harder to fight Ziggs. Due to the fact that Ziggs has all of that bonus health you can bring back. And are we about to see set using to Mordekaiser again, putting Mordekaiser in the power of but here we're looking at bottom line getting the different Nautilus going down. What? Callista going through taking out Ziggs and Aphelios goes through and takes down Warwick along with the Morgana and Mordekaiser. Allowing Mordekaiser to get away with his life and his kills. And there it is. Red team proceeding to spawn Rift Herald dead middle of the map. Going through trying to end this game probably as soon as possible. They're proceeding to they take the second tower. They're putting at red team at a lead of 3 towers and the blue team 0. Along with an extra 10 kills on blue. This is not looking good for blue team, but could they turn this around? Oh, there it is. Mordekaiser is getting a double kill and a triple kill for Aphelios, taking that set away from the Mordekaiser. Mordekaiser going through killing Callista and Nautilus, definitely putting him at an even further power skill than he originally was. Oh, and there it is. Ziggs also taking first tower for bottom. That is going to put Blue on a very defensive scale. And I guess we're going to probably find out what happens. Oh, there it is. Close to taking a kill with the bottom, but getting stunned. And there goes the Yumi, but too bad, Aphelios was there, poking away at the Callista. Callista going down to Aphelios, but does manage to get Ziggs and Yumi. I would say that would be worth trade, but at this current late in the game, probably not. Red team also then proceeding to take Mountain Drake, giving their team an even bigger defense bonus in the Infernal Soul. Basically, Infernal Soul is bonus overall damage. Their team using ability, it does its own bonus damage. So, pretty wide. And there it is. Mordekaiser getting a double kill, but then instantly getting shut down by Malzahar. He's definitely going to go through and suffer from that death, giving Malzahar 700 gold to play around with. Not enough to get any of the good items, but definitely going through and getting a start on them. And here's Callista poking at Morgana, but then instantly getting looted and losing a lot of health. And there's Callista going down to Morgana. Warwick trying to do something but backing off instead of trying it. Red team probably trying to take out Baron Terrapin and spawning the second team. Oh, but what is this bottom? Aphelios getting jumped by 4 people. We do see Aphelios die here. But then there it is, Malzahar going through, going down to Mordekaiser. Morgana and Mordekaiser are trying to take out Baron Nashor, while Ziggs tries to take tower. Ziggs being able to do a lot of damage to tower before tower goes through, before he has to launch away due to Nautilus approaching. Oh, and there Nautilus is getting slowed down and using his opponent's flash. Definitely a big use for him, but on the other hand, not so decent for them. Here we are watching blue team fight into the jungle. This looks to be a 4v4? No, 4v5, because Yumi is there, just being an AFP. There's a common jet going around, and it's a heavy. Oh no, Callista and Nautilus both going down. Blue team pursuit. Could this be the end? Warwick is also down to Mordekaiser. That could definitely go through and change this matchup so far. Guys are doing some toxic things here, I guess. Curtis set going down to Mordekaiser. This does seem to look like it's going to be game. Putting Red Team into the semi-final. No. I'm further into this bracket. Malzahar poking at Ziggs, killing his legs. Red team spamming that Inferno Drift as in fact, spawning in 30 seconds. Proceeding to be pulled in and done again. She did not stand a chance versus him. Red team taking Infernal Drake. Knight going through, solidifying 3 Drakes to blue team's 0. 5 towers, 28 kills to their 11, 0 towers for blue. Proceeding to be double kill on set Nautilus and Warwick as triple kill. Going through, they're also being a button power. This quickly being up on him. And those are proceeding to back to a kill as they're looking to end this game right here, right now. Here we are, blue red team proceeding to take the tower and inhibitor. Oh boy. Ophelios taking the tower. Blue proceeding to blue proceeding to Preston's. Ophelios, Morgana.
is right there and kind of less killing you, but losing again. And that is good.